I went on Pinterest and I saw these really cool like sigil door hangings or wall hangings, and I decided I have got to make one of those for myself. So we're going to start with the materials that we're going to need for this project. So we're going to need a hot glue gun, some twine or some string. I got this from the Dollar Tree, so it was only a dollar for this whole thing. So you're not going to need to spend a lot of money. And then you're going to need sticks. Lots and lots of sticks. Actually, I didn't use that many. Now to get these sticks, I actually just foraged behind my job. I just, after work, I went out there. There's like a forest out there behind my job. So I went out back there and I walked in the forest and I just grabbed whatever sticks looked like they'd work for me. Mostly you want sticks that are around the same shape and size and texture. I mean, they don't have to be depending on your project, but mine was. Now the next thing you want to do, obviously, is make your sigil. So in order to make mine, I just used like the basic chart, like one of the most popular charts to use, which is the letters and the numbers. And, you know, I'll go more into this, I guess, if you guys want me to one day, but I don't technically follow it like the exact way. I basically use the chart to help me get like the basic shape that I want. And then from there, I work with it until I have something that actually looks good to me, especially when it's something I'm going to be building and putting on the wall. You know, you want it to at least look a little aesthetically pleasing. So I basically get the basic shape I want and then I go from there. Now for this, I tried out a couple of different ways. I tried using the word as one, I tried using the word as two, and that's how I got my basic shape. Then I laid it out on a larger sheet of paper, and then I just color coded it so that way I knew how many sticks I needed, because I get confused sometimes, just so that I know what I needed to do and where I needed to glue or use string. You know, at that point I wasn't sure which one I was gonna do where, but I knew I was gonna do both. Once I had my basic design out and knew how many sticks I needed, I then proceeded to just break the sticks into the basic sizes that I needed. I needed two to be the same length and then two to be a little bit longer. And then I needed the center one to be the longest out of all of them. It took me a couple of tries to get it the way I wanted. I laid it out a couple times. I switched the sticks a couple times. I broke a couple more just because when I laid them out, I wanted to make sure that it was going to lay the exact way I wanted it. And then I just hot glued each piece together, you know, just one section at a time, just working one at a time. I didn't try to glue it all together at once, just one at a time, going slowly, making sure it's gonna look the way I want it to look, because you know, you want it to be a nice finished product in the end. This is why I actually think it's really important to get way more sticks than you feel like you're gonna need, because I definitely broke some too short and then that stick was not usable because then the other side was also too short, and then some of them I was not able to use at all because my stick breaking skills are not the greatest. So that's why you want more sticks than what you know you're going to use, because you're going to need extras, definitely. Especially because this was the first time that I was doing one of these, so it was a little bit hard just to, you know, figure out how I wanted it to lay out exactly. Not lay out, just figure out how I wanted the sticks to like lay on top of each other and which side I wanted to be the front and the back. I eventually decided on the side that I was working on was going to be the front side, just because the other side, I guess you could see more of the glue, and this side just looked a little bit more finished to me, at least in my head it did. Now the one stick that's different on these is the center stick, but I didn't mind that so much just because it's the center one, so it can be a little bit different. Once I had everything all glued up, I was deciding if I wanted to put string on it. It wasn't necessary, but I felt like it made it look a little bit more finished to me without the string. The sticks just kind of looked a little floaty, and I felt like the string just grounded it a little bit. So I basically just tied the back and then wrapped it around as many times as it would go, and then I just hot glued whatever little piece was left over. I just hot glued it down so that way you didn't see it. And I only did this at the points where two sticks would meet on top of each other, not at like the corners where they're just hanging out together, you know, only where sticks are like exactly on top of each other in an X. I felt like that was the best spots to put it in, where it looked really nice. And once I had everything wrapped up, I was all done with my very first sigil wall hanging. I decided to put this in my kitchen just because that particular spot on the wall was a little blank to me, so I put it in there just for a little extra something. You know, I needed something on the wall. But once I put it there, it looked a little empty now, and like it looks like it needs friends. So I'm probably gonna make just some four element ones to go along with it at some point. Maybe like two on one side and two on another side. Anyways, this is all done. If you like this video, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and I will see you in the next one.